Hi, I'm Sam Bilotto with Bilotto Services, and I'm an expert in the process of shooting, grading, and mastering HDR video. Today, I'm talking about my experience testing the Atomos Neon 24. Atomos recently released its Neon, its much-anticipated new flagship monitor system with HDR capabilities. This is an amazing production HDR monitor, and when used with the proper color management, it will be an excellent tool in your HDR production workflow. On the other hand, its studio HDR grading capabilities are a little lacking right out of the box. Though, if you know what you're doing in HDR, it's still a great platform you can adapt to studio grading, like the Atomos Sumo. There is a lot to love about the Neon, and I had been eagerly awaiting to get my hands on one to try out when I got the opportunity to test one with my friends and partners at Paradox Post. After testing the Neon 24, I still have a lot that I love about the display. But like with the Atomos Sumo, Atomos has overpromised and underdelivered on the studio HDR capabilities of the display. First, what I love. The display is set up to get future hardware upgrades by swapping out the control module. This is ingenious and means that the panel will be useful for years to come, even as standards change and are upgraded. The display is rugged. This was built for the production environment, though the display's high power draw ironically means that it's hard to use in rugged locations, since at the moment it can't be battery powered. Being built for the production environment means that the display will happily interpret any camera log signals you send it and render it into the display's SDR. That's great. But the hard part about this for me is that Atomos hasn't published how they move from log to the display, meaning that I can't reproduce the Neon's look in color correction later when grading my content. Another downside with the log processing is that when the Neon is operating in log or HDR mode, it won't process LUTs. These two things mean that if you want to use the Neon as part of a DIT deployment, you're going to need to map into the Neon's native dynamic range and color space using a LUT, with all color processing turned off at the display. That's doubly true for HDR, which we'll talk about here in a moment. Another big plus for me is the new Atom Remote app that connects your smartphone or tablet to the display over Bluetooth and allows you to change settings without having to touch the screen. That said, the connection is occasionally finicky, and I managed to get the whole system locked up at one point during my tests. So what about its HDR? In the past, I've recommended the Sumo as a tool to get started with HDR in the grading suite, but I said that you needed a set of custom LUTs that I built to map the HDR dynamic range into the display's native dynamic range. That's because the HDR on the Sumo wasn't mapped correctly and reduced the image contrast. That's far less of an issue on the Neon, but it still is an issue. After calibrating the Neon, and calibration is essential, you still need to adjust the settings on the display to get the most accurate PQ HDR image. I compared the Neon to the Sony BVMX300, the FSI XM310K, the Small HD OLED 22, and the Apple Pro Display XDR. The HDR image on all four of the other displays matched, but out of the box, the Neon didn't, which I confirmed using a color probe. In order to get the closest, most accurate HDR image, I had to adjust the picture settings using the Atom Remote app. Here's what worked for me. Backlight to 100, lift to -4, gamma to 2.44, and gain to 1.24. Once I had that dialed in, the display was mostly okay for HDR color correction, except for a few big things. First, the middle ground saturations were all too low, which you can see on the calibration results. Looking at it in person, you could clearly see a color difference between the Neon and the other zone array displays, as well as the two OLEDs I was testing at the same time. That means that if you use it for grading, you're likely to boost your saturations beyond what they should be. Second, the zone array algorithm on the display seemed to favor peak brightness in a zone over the overall exposure of the zone, which means that I saw an awful lot of elevated blacks and false contours, the worst of any zone array we looked at as part of our comparisons, and worse than my personal TV at home. Third, the HLG mode on the display follows the BBC's standard for displays. That sounds like it should be okay, but ITUR Recommendation 2100 put specific interpretation limits to HLG for use in signal reference. These are largely patterned after the display characteristics of the Sony BVMX300, but are important to adhere to in the grading environment, since Rec 2100 is the only way to cross-convert between PQHDR and HLG-HDR. If you send the Neon already graded HLG content, it will look good, like HLG does, but it won't be reference accurate. Lastly, and this is super important, because you can't load LUTs to the Neon in HDR mode, your HDR grading is going to be limited to using the P3 gamut instead of the Rec 2020 gamut, unless you're using older I/O cards or boxes. Newer SDI cards use the Rec 2020 non-constant transfer matrix when working in Rec 2020, consistent with the latest SDI specifications. The Neon, like pretty much every other monitor on the market, still uses the older Rec 709 matrix, leading to hue and brightness shifts when you send the Neon a Rec 2020 signal. I usually fix that at the display with a custom-built technical LUT. But since I can't load LUTs into the HDR mode on the Neon, that's not an option. I'm going to make a whole video on the subject at some point soon, so if that's something that interests you, let me know in the comments below and go ahead and subscribe. All of that said, the Neon is a marvelous display for the price point. Overall, it looks really good. Its SDR reference looks fantastic, and with a little bit of configuration, the HDR reference does as well, though its high power draw, fan noise, and size make it better suited for a DIT deployment than for use in the grading suite. If you want to grade using this display or use it in a DIT setting, your best option is to map your standard signals into the native panel characteristics using a LUT. This is far more involved of a solution than I would prefer, but you'll get great results if you do. Unlike with the Sumo, I haven't created any LUTs for this display, since I didn't have it for long enough to go through the time it would take, and wasn't going to be using it for myself on a day-to-day basis. One last note, I did my tests on the Neon 24, which uses a different display panel than the Neon 17, which uses a much more limited 1080p panel with an 8+2-bit driver like the Sumo. If you have any questions about my experience using the display, leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more tips, tricks, and tools for working in HDR. I'm Sam Bilodeau, and I'll see you soon.